whispers the little card, he says, Dave, over at Heroic Replicas. Might do a close-up of that card. He makes these Mastersword replicas. And he wanted to do a collaboration. And I said, sounds good to me. It's times like this that I wish I had one of those press button on the back style TIG welders. For some reason, grown-up welders don't like them. But I weld in so many weird, awkward positions. Like I hardly ever do old runs. Oh, being able to tack things at odd angles would actually be way more useful for me. So I use the thing. Everything is the correct distance. I can't find it to see the screwdriver now, but just little tweaks of a screwdriver, little tightenings of these. So, to the best of my ability, this is in the correct place, so I can get a great big weld here and a great big weld here. Position. Get some more weld around here. Stick the pommel on. Okay, so at this very late stage in making the sword, I encounter a problem. This was obviously two halves of a mold that got squished together. But most of the depictions of the Master Sword I've seen, they show the thing as being this-a-way. But the problem with this-a-way, where this line here lines up with the sword, is the back of this guy isn't a square. Or it's not symmetrical through every plane. Like it would be, actually I would love to mount it this way. But that's not how, wasn't able to find any depiction, like was it a matter of opinion? All of them mount this way. So I think I'm just gonna have to mount it this way and not think about it too hard. Come on. So this is actually only stuck on with drafting dots. So the other side of this piece of leather, I ordered this leather online. Do I have a sample of it here? I don't know how the color and the lights in here will pick it up, but it was completely the wrong color. And I tried darkening, just make it darker, and it was just darker. And then I dyed this piece and threw in some green. See, this other side of it's too green. And now it's too light, but the problem with lighter colors is keeping them clean. I think this one would darken down as it's actually used by people who are grubby hands to the right colors.
Hang on.
It looks completely wrong in here. Yeah, I know, the light in here is different because it's artificial light now. But in natural light, these look way closer. I give up. I'm using this piece of leather. Yeah, I think I'm ready to start putting it on. But I'm slightly stressed out about how finicky this is going to be. Yet again, this is the leathercraft cement stuff. There's so little of it left. I might actually cut the top off this bottle. I'm going to try to make a note to order some new stuff. It's very important that I line up the tip of this. Should have gotten some toothpicks. Maybe I did get some toothpicks. Something to push this in with. How far up? Oh, it's not even that far. Okay, so gotta get the glue out again. I love the way this glue almost instantly joins. So I'm gonna leave this here. Okay, get the glue again. I didn't want to overdo it with the glue because I thought it would take some finagling, and I didn't want to be finagling with glue that was drying and stuff, but I think it's going to be fine. Oh, and I should have mentioned that I'm using the suede side. The suede side came out way closer to the correct color than the leather side, and I treated the suede side with waterproofing stuff. What I meant by toothpicks. Something to rub this in with. Squish it in. Oh, it's moving around. I'm gonna wait till that sticks on before I do the next part. So what I've done here, because I was nervous that it was going to look wonky, is I squeezed a piece of paper around the outside so I could get an outline of the stripes, and then reversed it, and then taped it, and then cut it out so that I could get a thing that looks like what the second overlapping string of stuff looks like. And so I don't get confused while I'm messing with wet glue while doing this. I'm just gonna put a series of dots where string number one overlaps, I'm putting one, and where the strand two overlaps, I'm putting two dots. It's very simple. I'm just super paranoid about getting confused about what I'm doing while it's all wet. So this is what that thing looked like, the tracing of this other one. Whew! See, this is why I was afraid of getting confused, because it looks so weird. I often wonder how they get some of these very fancy leather wrap type things on traditional sword handles. And the answer appears to be, after looking at a few of those videos, is they always put the sword handle is always like a separate screw off part. So they can do incredibly fancy things with the handle because it's not actually part of the sword. You know, like they screw it on and stuff, but it's not like a permanent part of the sword when they're doing this extremely fancy stuff. And poor old me, I mean, this, I guess this is a sword where you could have made a screw off handle, but it's just not how I make them. I generally make them that the handle is like a welded on component that's like a permanent fixture. So that's why I wind up having to do this stuff with struggling with putting the leather on while it's on the blade, which is not ideal. But I prefer having that than I don't know, it's probably fine with the smaller ones, but for the giant ones especially, I would never want a screw on handle. Oh, okay, I'm going in to eat my dinner. So as I was brassing this, something boiled out from underneath here. I'd sprayed the sword blade with WD-40 while I was waiting for the anodized parts to come back, and I acetoned it and wiped it down, and I thought I had gotten all the stuff off, but apparently not. Or inside the piece itself there was some other mystery chemical from the anodizing place itself, although that also seems unlikely. So I think it was just stray bits of WD-40 boiling out from underneath. That's the sword finished. If you've been following along on my YouTube, you know that I've been making other stuff related to the test video, so I guess we might as well get on with that. Thank you to Dave at Heroic Replicas for sending me the aluminum parts, without which it would have just been a total... I could have done it, but it would have been even more work, and I couldn't have got the lovely blue colour if it wasn't aluminum. Just to reiterate, this is a charity build, so this will be going up for auction. For details of the charity auction, check the video description.
For Dave, check the video description. If you have a Link outfit similar to my Link outfit and you need the final finishing piece, this will probably be the only time I'm making one because it was an unusual set of circumstances. So send me a message.
Ooh.